Colin, maybe you can get rid of the image now, or Miranda.
Hello, everyone.
Good to see my friends again. Hi, Charles. Good to see you. Welcome.
Thank you. I'm mostly here.
We'll get you all the way here. Our job today. So all of you that are here, please put on your video so we can feel connected with you. Some who've been here already know the drill. Hey, Jeannie, good to see you. Welcome. Hi, Joni. Jay, good to see you again. And Tammy, Teresa, all my old friends. We go back a long time, Tammy. I told Gail about you the other night. She was happy to know you're part of this.
Wonderful.
Carol, I think I want to go where you are. That is a wonderful background. So let us begin while we are waiting. Hey, Heidi, good to see you. You're looking very, I don't know what, with that hat on. Cool. So while we're waiting for some more people to join us, let's do a check-in on how the day went. You had an assignment last night. You had 24 hours to practice opportunities for unity with different people in your life. Not that it necessarily had to happen. It might have, might not have, but I'd love to hear from people how that went for them. Anyone feels inspired to share? Anyone have any opportunities for unity moments today, where you were helping people move from division into unity? Where you were helping yourself move from being in some divided place with someone or something into unity? Okay. How was your day, Joni? Any opportunities to practice?
Mostly I was listening into Unity Earth programs today and just doing some busy work while I did that.
Oh, that's nice. So you had a lovely day then, not a lot of opportunities to transform anything.
No, not much interaction.
Okay, fair enough. Charles, are you here yet?
Sure. It's fascinating to revisit the word unity. I'm still herding cats from a half a dozen World Unity Week events that have not yet been finalized. So I can't find a segue yet into unitization of any of that, but I'm willing.
Okay. Well, that's a good start. That is a great start. So wait another moment or two, see if anyone has anything to share. Now Sherry's here, uh-oh. Not uh-oh, but yay. Maybe uh-oh for her, depends. So any opportunities today, Sherry? I think you are.
I'm afraid you're gonna call on me.
Well, yes, I told you, I'm just preparing you. Each day I may call on
I love
you.
It.
I called on four or five people already, by the way, so I'm not just.
Oh, good, good. Well, I'm sorry I'm late. I'm totally game. Yeah, huge opportunities I'm dealing with.
Right.
Very difficult situations with a father past lawyer who can't be trusted, who's the trustee. So you're supposed to trust him. And then I have to be really diplomatic and then the wife and the ex-wife, you know, there's all this like dynamics and I have to stand in this place of like connectedness and not let my frequency go into fear and then protection and not trust, but also be vigilant. So it really was such a space of like, okay, I can breathe into this. And what I've experienced was more in the practice was more peace, that then I could feel just more peace in how to navigate something that felt tender. It's very tender. And then people are misbehaving. So it isn't just that there's like, oh, I'm just grieving. It's like, no, misbehaving. So I was grateful for the practice. And I realized it was like, what a great practice.
How would you say you did on practicing being better, in a community place rather than a divided place today?
I would say that I noticed that I have to devote more. Today was very busy from like the moment I was up at like 6:30. It was kind of one of those days that a lot was being asked of me, like I had to be on. And so I was like, well, I'm going to get up early and I'm going to carve out time. And I feel like there's something about, I have this idea that has to take a lot of time. And I think that's actually not true, but maybe it's the repatterning of something that actually is the time, takes the time in the practice. But in the moment, I don't have to like spend 45 minutes. It can actually happen more quickly. So that I think is sort of my edge a little bit.
Okay, I think that's a beautiful growing, not a beautiful in the sense that it isn't easy, but it is beautiful in the sense that you're working your growing edge. Mm-hmm. Now we have to practice what Annie did the other day with her putting out the light and then seeing what comes back, because that's the practice. The practice is really about diffusing in the hearts of those where you might feel divided or who come from a place of being divided or a place of division, and letting the light do the heavy lifting.
Oh, that's nice. Letting the light do the heavy lifting. Beautiful.
It should be easier for you.
Mm-hmm.
And it can be.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, any other comments or anything anyone else wants to share about how their day went vis-a-vis practicing either unity or oneness or empowerment, any of the other frequencies we've worked on over the last 3 days? Okay, Teresa, please tell us.
Yeah, hello everybody. Listen for the first time to the presentation on unity. And that was just very easy for me to slip into or vibe with, let's just say. And the little stone I got was scolatite. I had to look it up. I didn't know. I just saw it. So I've got a little bag here with a ruby, a golden healer, and a scolazite. That was from day one, right?
Yeah.
And it was just, it's just something sort of fun, something to help me anchor the energies in my own field here. And I just happened to have them. So thank you.
Well, I love, oh, wow. People are actually manifesting real pouches. And you have real stones in yours as well, Sherry. I love it. Again, I think you're muted, Sherry.
Yes, I do. I have them sort of in my house, and they called to me. It was like, do you want to be part of this? This is the empowerment crystal. And this is the oneness stone, which is a shell of perfection, of the perfection of the universe. And this was the stone of unity. So yes. We'll see what wants to go into that. I want to talk about at some point the power of the process of actually putting these magical powers in that whole part of it. I think we should do a longer version of that, because that is super activating. I mean, there's a lot going on when that's happening. I'm like, wow, there's dormant capacities in me that I didn't even know.
Okay, people are showing off their favorite stuff. Yes. Okay. I'm very excited about that. So obviously these stones are showing up in your life. Now, I don't know how to pronounce your name. Was it Wazi? Am I getting it right?
Yes, that is right. Wazi Hayoka.
Wonderful name. So Wazi, what are your stones? What are the magical properties of your stones?
Oh, David, really?
I mean, you don't have to reveal them, but if you are willing.
Oh, no. No, you're asking a delightful question. And look at that smile. I appreciate your smile very, very much, especially that I was able to facilitate it. No, I am a stone lover, rock lover from day one. I mean, I got stones all over the house. You can't believe it. But anyway, and I make neck pieces out of stones. But this stone, there are two stones that ride with me all the time. This is a black lingam. Now, you might know what a lingam is, right?
I don't, but I'm happy to know more. Tell me.
A lingam is a stone from India that came from rivers. And they're always shaped this way. And you can see it's an egg shape, and it's actually a stone of balance. It has the male genital, and then it has the female ovum. So it represents the balance between male and female, and you don't see many black lingams. And so when I saw this black lingam, of course I'm buying you immediately. I was in California. I saw three more. I bought those immediately, and they're just really, really special.
So which of the frequencies does that one represent? Have you given it its?
Well, certainly it represents love and peace. You know, and when we can be at peace because of love, then we can be joyful.
Okay. Right?
So the other piece, I'll show you quickly, the other piece. Now, this is the shape of a circle, right? Now, the circle is the shape of the divine. Divinity is in the shape of a circle. I practice shamanism. That's why you see Wazi Hayoka. It's Lakota. Those words are Lakota. And this stone is blue, and it's lapis lazuli, which has fool's gold in it. And blue is the color of peace.
Nice.
So here I have peace in the form of divinity, or divinity in the form of peace. And I'm all about peace. My email is peacemaker. My card says make peace. So these balance, love, joy, peace, it's all what it is. Thank you for asking. It's really a treat.
You're welcome. Now, Wazi, have you been here the last 3 days perchance?
No, I have not. This is my first time.
Okay, so you are going to have a lot more fun then, because you're going to discover a magical stone in our meditation this evening, and you're going to also discover that you have three other stones in a pouch, ready to be named and imbued with magical powers. So you've already teed up two stones that are candidates for such an opportunity. So stay tuned, and then those stones will have a little bit more meaning for you than they already have. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
David, I have something to share too, real fast.
All right, Miranda, go for it.
Yeah, just I've been through these frequency meditations multiple times before, and each time it profoundly changes me or gives me new realizations. So it's amazing how, you know, just as you were talking about, Sherry, making it a practice is really the thing. And then when we don't keep the practice, we fall off of it too. Or it's just always amazing to me that I have new realizations, even when you think a lot of this stuff has landed. And for me, yesterday, well, empowerment is about, you know, love, the frequency of embodying peace within yourself and empowering yourself to the greatest level and holding that frequency, but also empowering those around you to have that within themselves. They're empowered. And then oneness is about us becoming one with the one person right with you or next to you. It belongs to the action befriending, but actually befriending another person, very personal relationships. And I didn't find so much, I felt the field was just kind of clear for me in those places. But when I got to unity, there were a lot of realizations that I had yesterday. And I reached out to people that I realized there was a lot of stress there or a lack of unity, mostly on my part because of not communicating that there was this stress and this separation. So I did reach out to them last night, asked for conversations this morning. was a little bit scared because these are kind of stressful people in my life. But things worked out beautifully with them, you know, tearfully, beautifully, in ways that I feel so much more peace today, and that I had those conversations. And I mean, it's also an epiphany to me of like, why did I have to go through that yesterday to even realize that that separation and stress was there, and that I could have reached out to them weeks ago and kind of cleared this up? Or I was scared that we wouldn't have unity, or that it would be conflict if I reached out. But it was all of that was in my head. They were so glad I reached out. They wanted unity also. They wanted to make it right. So it was beautiful that that happened. So thank you.
Fantastic, Miranda. You're such a role model. You are such a student of life, and you always go for it. And I'm always so appreciative of that quality that you have. So thank you for being such a model. And of course, good job. Your life is better as a result. Okay, so we are going to begin our meditations. So for those that have not been here before, I will guide you through a meditation, and we will enter into the cooperation frequency. Cooperation frequency moves us into a more active place of these different frequencies, because it demands an action on our part to cooperate with an other, to produce something greater than we could do by ourselves. I call it cooperation for the common good. So it's not just cooperation, but making the world a better place through cooperation with another. World Unity Week is an example of cooperation for the common good. So many groups coming together. Our Peace on Earth partners, of which some of you are here. Charles is one of them. Heidi, I don't know if she's here at the moment. She's another one. Are all cooperating for the common good. And it's a beautiful thing to watch and behold. Not common, which is why cooperation is so important. Okay, so with that said, let me take you on the journey. So take a deep breath. Breathe in really deeply. And as you breathe in, as you allow this breath into your lungs and your body, experience peace within yourself and affirm, I am in harmony with self. I am in harmony with self. Affirm, I am, you can do this silently, in harmony with self. And let that in. And on the second breath, experience yourself at peace with all the people in your life. With all the people at your life. All the people in your life. So Sherry, great opportunity for you right now and others. And affirm, I am in harmony with others. I am in harmony with others. And just feel in your heart this sense of harmony radiating out from you to all the people in your life. I am in harmony with others. And now on the third breath, experience yourself at peace with the earth and all living beings who inhabit it, and affirm, I am in harmony with the earth and all living beings. I am in harmony with the earth and all living beings. And just feel this sense of being in harmony with the beautiful energies of our planet Earth, of Gaia, and all the beings on planet Earth. Just feel that sense of harmony in your fullness of your being. Feel that harmony with others and feel that harmony with self. And let's take a minute to just allow that in. Just give yourself some time to be in that place of harmony. Now open yourself to your soul, your spirit guides, your angelic helpers, and invite their guidance as you take this journey of cooperation. Invite in all the spiritual support in your life and allow that spiritual support to guide you on this journey. And the frequency we'll be working with this evening is green cooperation light, which represents growth and the color of cooperation. The natural world is a role model of cooperation. Ecosystems are role models of cooperation. So allow the green cooperation light into your being, and we will work with that light this evening. Now visualize your heart filled with green cooperation light. And the first question of our journey this evening: what is my growing edge in transforming any competition I may have with others into cooperation for the common good? What is my growing edge in transforming any competition I may have with others, often not stated, but felt somewhere in your body or your mind or your heart? Competition I may have with others into cooperation for the common good. And allow any words or images to emerge and record them. A piece of paper, smartphone, iPad, whatever is available. What is my growing edge in transforming any competition I may have with others into cooperation for the common good? One way to tell if you're in that place of competition is when you feel separation or judgment of yourself or others. And we move on. Visualize the hearts of your family members filled with green cooperation light. The hearts of your family members filled with green cooperation light. What is my growing edge in helping my family members transform any competition they may have with others into cooperation for the common good? What is my growing edge in helping my family members transform any competition they may have with others into cooperation for the common good? and allow any words or an image to emerge. Record that reflects your intuition as to what this growing edge is for you. Now visualize the hearts of your friends filled with green cooperation light. The hearts of your friends filled with green cooperation light. What is my growing edge in helping my friends transform any competition they may have with others into cooperation for the common good? What is my growing edge in helping my friends transform any competition they may have with others into cooperation for the common good? And allow any words or an image to emerge and record them. You are transforming all the people in your life as you step into this, or you have an opportunity to. Now visualize the hearts of your co-workers filled with green cooperation light. Visualize the hearts of your co-workers filled with green cooperation light. What is my growing edge in helping my co-workers transform any competition they may have with others into cooperation for the common good? And that is within the business or within the relationships you have with your coworkers, and between their work and other businesses. The whole notion of transformation from competition to cooperation is an opportunity now to get transformed. What does that look like for you? What's your growing edge in helping facilitate that? Now visualize the hearts of your community members filled with green cooperation light. And that includes all the groups in all the businesses, as well as all the people in your community. What is my growing edge in helping my community members transform any competition they may have with others into cooperation for the common good? And allow any words or an image to emerge and record them. We're building on the agency of empowerment, the first frequency, oneness, the second frequency, unity, the third frequency, all of those will assist you in this transformation of competition consciousness into cooperation consciousness. A very high frequency. And in particular, cooperation for the common good, cooperation that lifts everything and everyone to a higher level. Now visualize the hearts of humanity, your fellow humans, our fellow humans, filled with green cooperation light. What is my growing edge in helping people across the planet transform any competition they may have with others into cooperation for the common good? And allow any words or an image to emerge and record them. My growing edge in helping people across the planet transform any competition they may have with others into cooperation for the common good. Now visualize your magical pouch. For some of you, you don't have to visualize it. You literally have it in front of you. But for those that don't, visualize your magical pouch. And in it, along with your empowerment, oneness, and unity jewel stones, you will now discover your cooperation jewel stone to support you on your hero's journey toward creating peace on earth by 2030. Take out this cooperation jewel stone and examine its color, its shape, its size, and its texture. Really get to know this stone. It may be an actual stone that you have in your possession, or it may be one that you create in your imagination. Now ask your cooperation jewel stone to tell you of its magical power to support your hero's journey. This is a talisman that will be imbued with this magical power and support you on your hero's journey to help create peace on earth. And write it down. If you do not participate in the other meditations, ask these jewel stones to tell you of their magical powers to support your hero's journey. The other jewel stones being empowerment, oneness, and unity. And write down what you received. Now put your jewel stone or stones back in your pouch to absorb the high frequency we will collectively generate across the planet. So we're now going to raise the cooperation frequency of the planet. And it will begin with the people in your network and then move out through them to others. So visualize your heart filled with green cooperation light. This beautiful quality of green that activates within your heart the desire for and the skill in cooperating for the common good. lifts you out of separation, out of division, out of victim, into cooperation. Now see and feel this green cooperation light spreading from your heart to the hearts of your family members to spread it to others. So it goes to them, and then they spread it to others effortlessly as their frequency is rising and raised. They naturally spread to others, and their frequency rises by virtue of you offering them this light. They will either receive it or not, but even if they don't fully receive it, it will just be a positive energy that is infusing their energy field. And if they do receive it, then it will start to diffuse through them. Now see and feel this green cooperation light spreading from your heart to the hearts of your friends who spread it to others. Again, your friends are a network through which cooperation light can be diffused to all the people in their networks. So visualize that. See that happening. See them receiving it and see them spreading it. Now see and feel this green cooperation light spreading from your heart to the hearts of your co-workers who spread it to others throughout their workplaces or your workplace. And other workplaces that are separate from their immediate business. So see it spreading through workplaces, through your coworkers. See the world of business transforming from competition to cooperation. What does that look and feel like? When we can spend our energy cooperating for the common good, which serves everyone, including the people cooperating, of course. Now see and feel this green cooperation light spreading from your heart to the hearts of your community members who spread it to others. Now experience your community as a place where people are cooperating for the common good. It's becoming the new social norm. It's just what we do in our community. See and experience and feel that. Now see and feel this green cooperation light spreading from your heart to the hearts of all of humanity. So this one expands you way beyond your current definition of self for most people. So hold yourself as someone big enough, expanded enough, wide enough in your energy field, the whole humanity. And see this green cooperation light spreading from your heart to the hearts of all of humanity, and feel all of humanity in your heart. And see yourself lifting the frequency of everyone on the planet by virtue of diffusing this green cooperation light. So keep expanding, because you've just got a lot bigger, a lot larger, a lot more expansive. And now see and feel this green cooperation light spreading from your heart to the hearts of your spirit guides and angelic helpers who spread it across the entire universe. You are now influencing the entire universe and all the beings, all the advanced galactic civilizations, all consciousness, learning how to cooperate for the common good. Now see and feel this green cooperation light as a luminous light that's now fully potentiated, lifting you and every part of your circle into ever higher frequencies of cooperation. You are now a master of cooperation. You are skillful. You are effective. Everywhere you go, you touch whatever situation you are in, and you help it get uplifted into cooperating for the common good. Now see and feel your community, the place that you reside, tipping into the cooperation frequency and being a community that is now modeling on the planet cooperation for the common good, which enables everything to operate from a much higher level of synergy, possibility, creativity. Because all the energy is going into this place of cooperating, a cooperating system is born. Now see and feel your community tipping other communities into the cooperation frequency across the world, which lifts your community in this ever-evolving spiral. And now see and feel our planet Earth tipped into the cooperation frequency. We are now approaching that place that advanced civilizations get to, when there's no energy of competition, but all the energy is melding together to create beautiful cooperation, frequencies, beautiful multicellular organisms, beautiful constellations. Now see and feel every human heart filled with the cooperation frequency. It is now the social norm on planet Earth, as it is many other places in our universe. And allow this fully into your body. Experience it in your body, into your heart. What are the emotions? What are the feelings? Into your mind, what are the thoughts? And into your soul, which thrives on these higher frequencies and offers you gratitude for allowing it to be fed and nourished by these higher frequencies. And just bask in this vision, just allow it in and spend a moment here. This is your guiding light, this meditation on the frequency of cooperation as you bring it into your life and as you step forward to play the game, where you'll get to practice this, as you'll get to practice all the other frequencies in very practical ways in all aspects of your life. And take a moment to record your experience so that it gets integrated and grounded. And if you feel inspired, you can share what you experienced in the chat. Take another few moments if you need it. And know that you have many, many other people listening in right now on Facebook. So while we are just the Zoom portion of this meditation, based on what we've experienced the last two nights, there's about almost 3,000 people listening in. So it's a big field we're building. So, anyone like to share anything about your experience of the meditation this evening? Okay, I will call on some people. Oh, there you go, Tammy. Thank you.
I have a question.
Questions, good.
So several times when you said cooperation and competition, the question that kept coming to me was, what about sports? It seems like the U.S. culture is so geared towards sports. And then internationally, when you look at like soccer and some other things, so what's your response to that?
Well, you know, there is an Olympic ideal, and the ideal of competition in the context of sport is that it enables you to be more than you would be had that other person not been there. It moves you to greater levels of excellence, and that's how sport can be at its best. And good sportsmanship is about learning how to be in good relationship with others. So it's a different kind of energy on the word competition than what tends to happen, which is often very aggressive and a zero sum. I mean, that is the nature of sport. But remember, it is sport. It is not necessarily life. And life is really where we're trying to deploy this. And in particular, cooperating for the common good. So it's a different energetic than sport. The main thing is, how do you see competition in your life or the world where we can lift it into cooperation? Because that's really the growing edge right now for humanity, is learning how to do that. Sport, I would say, is an opportunity to see some of the best of how you can use one another to excel in your own efforts. Sometimes people use the word coopetition. That's a term that's often used for that. Does that answer your question? What happened for you in the meditation beyond that question?
I lost my dear dad in September last year, and when you called in spirit guides, he immediately came to me. And he was a master cooperator. And it feels like, and I'm weak, but it feels like he is very much a role model for me to learn and model from.
Beautiful. Did he give you any specific guidance? It's a skill to cooperate. It doesn't just come naturally. I've learned that.
No, not that I can articulate right now, but
well, ask him, particularly as you choose to play the game, because one of the actions, action three of the game, action four of the game, is cooperating for the common good. And so you need to look into your life with whom you might cooperate and what that cooperation would look like and what the greater good could come out of that cooperation. So it starts to look at how to get greater levels of synergy, which is a word that's often used, but is not really understood, how to enable. So more to be said on that if you choose to play the game.
Thank you.
Anyone else have any reflections or questions or comments? Jay, good to hear your voice again.
Hey, good to be here. I was just really present in this, the last stage of the meditation with the angels among us. So like the energy of the angelic guides, like holding us in a way to step through the portal of cooperation and inviting, as we're inviting all of humanity and all of the angelic beings into true cooperation at that energetic level, to simply agree to step through the portal rather than, and yeah, that it would be just that easy, inviting that. Yeah, so that was the what I was really present to, is just feeling the angelic guides, like, you know, inviting me to step through the portal, but also inviting other people in my life to step through the portal too, with that simple step.
And did you choose to do that?
Yes.
Okay. I wait for tomorrow's class to hear how this goes for you over the next 24 hours. I look forward to hearing any reflections of opportunities for cooperation. They might be simple. Just when you have this frequency, things show up. I'm particularly interested to see how this plays out with you, Sherry, because you are clearly in this classroom. I mean, you're actually working a lot of the frequencies, but competition seems to be a dominant part of your current experience. So how did this go? How was the meditation for you? Did you
went really
light to these different people that are not getting along very well right now?
Yeah, this is definitely a wonderful opportunity for my growing edge to be in practice quite profoundly, actually. And you know, my experience of cooperation goes back with John Raymer, probably 20 years, with Howard Rheingold and the Institute for the Future, and the Stanford Humanities Lab, where we did a class for 10 weeks and then we continued for 6 years, a group of us. It was called Towards a Literacy of Cooperation.
Oh, nice. And
yeah, and so it was game theory and all sorts of interesting things. And but we stayed in a group that dwindled down, but we stayed together for 6 years and we were a cooperation studies group. And so this is very alive for me. And the meditation went really deep for me tonight. It was like I kind of was going in and out of some multi-dimensional places. But what I saw was and felt was that as the green light was going out to humanity, that it was landing in hearts, like I could see this green light in the hearts of people, and that it was almost like something was dormant that then got like ignited. And then I could see the glow, the green in the hearts kind of like kind of taking root. It wasn't like I was just putting it there. It was almost like I was like touching and connecting and things were getting turned on and then growing. And it was like a very powerful, like a field of yearning for cooperation itself.
Hmm. Really, this is on your path and you've manifested an opportunity and it's a big one. So you get to practice this. And did you send light to the people in your life where there is competition going on now?
I was doing that earlier. And it's definitely, I forgot that part of the practice, which is like so ridiculously, it's like kind of silly that I forgot, but I did. And I can see how I have some resistance in me with certain people, like they're the hardest people on the planet for me. I can't even tell you. It's so hard. And because there was betrayal and there's all sorts of stuff. And so it's really, it's like, okay, that's mine. That's me, mine to do. So I'm right there at that like threshold.
Yeah.
It's a deep wound of abandonment with my father. I lost him to this woman when my mother died, and then this, you know, this, it's like betrayal, and it hurts. And then I'm like, I thought it was over when he died, and no, it's not, and it's right. I'm having to navigate it. So this is perfect. It's just perfect.
I was just thinking how great it is that you've manifested this, Sherry.
It's perfect. And so like, I'm all in.
So also practice forgiveness. That also is useful.
Oh, yeah.
Forgiveness is a good one. It frees up a lot of energy.
Yeah, I have to do that like every day. Every day is forgiveness.
So my friends, on that note, every day is forgiveness, opportunities for all of us when things don't go the way we want and people don't do the things that we might wish that they did, when we don't do the things that we wish we did. So lots to practice. I look forward to seeing you tomorrow. And we move into abundance, which also is a very important building block of generosity, spirit, as well as resources. So be well, have a beautiful evening, a beautiful 24 hours of practice, cooperation, and all the other good things that you are practicing. Many blessings. See you tomorrow. Be well.